Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the topic Creating Significant Learning Experiences. So in a single lecture, it is very difficult to create significant learning experience. And the people today, they are talking about experiential learning through some documentation, NAC documentation and NBA documentation. But not for the sake of documentation, it is for really for the welfare of the students. We require experiential learning, and we have to teach to create significant learning experience in students' mind. I am inspired by this book, Creating Significant Learning Experiences by D. Fink. So it is an interesting book. He is initially explaining why the experiential learning is required and what are all the method to design the lecture for experiential learning and to implement the lecture to create the experiential learning among the students. So the copy, if the copy is available at a free of cost in the Google, so you can search and collect the book and have a reading. I am preparing certain lecture using this book, and I am practicing certain point based on this book. So I want to share my experience, some of the important findings from the book. So today we all know the education system, what is happening is rote learning. So rote learning is nothing but the mug and vomit system. We are dumping the information. We teachers, not only in higher education, in school education also, the teachers are dumping the information in the minds of the students, either online or offline. Then at the end of the day, end of the semester, they vomit on the examination paper. So there ends the matter. But really, the students, this is what the today's higher education system or education system, but the children, they want some help. So why they want help? So because there are many difficulties they are facing in future. So they want to come out of the difficulties. To come out of the difficulty, they want a different methodology of education, different methodology of learning, teaching. So we won't meet the needs for more and better higher education until the professors become designer of learning experiences and not the teachers. So we have to create the experiential learning in the minds of the student by designing the lecture and not as a teacher. That is what the outcome-based education. So in the outcome-based education, what the student will do at the end of the lecture. So if you want the student to do something at the end of the lecture, we should not be teachers, simply teachers. We should make the student to work and learn, to experience and learn. That is what the experiential learning. Faculty members want their student to achieve higher kind of learning. So they want their student to achieve higher kinds of learning. They continue to use a form of teaching that is not effective at promoting such a learning. So we continue to teach in the old way what our teachers did. But today our students want to achieve higher learning, which is not at all possible using the teaching style what we follow inside the classroom. So what kind of result does lecturing, even good lecturing, produces? So we are just lecturing in the classroom. So what will happen? The conventional lecturing has limited effectiveness in helping the student to retain the information after the course is over. So this we find in all the colleges, all the system of education, school education, college education, The students, they are not able to retain the information for a longer time. After the examination, they will forget everything. Even first semester mathematics differential calculus, they forget immediately after the first semester. If you have some application of the differential calculus in future higher semester, it is very difficult for them to recall. So, develop an ability to transfer the knowledge to the novel situation. So, this is again, so they are not able to understand things and transfer the information, transfer the knowledge to a novel situation. Develop the skill in thinking and problem solving. So, problem solving on their own. So, they are not, it is not just the problem what we solve, they repeat. So, they have to solve problem on their own. So, for that, they have to think. They have to understand the basic theory. They have to remember the basic theory and the equation. Achieve effective outcomes such as motivation for additional learning or a change in the attitude. So, the learning should create the change in the attitude of the student, change in the mindset of the student. And the teaching or the learning should motivate them for additional learning. So, what they learn from the classroom, that motivate, that should motivate them for additional learning outside the classroom. So, this in the conventional lecturing style, all these things are not happening. So, we require something different in the classroom. So, one more finding, at the end of the lecture, the average level of students recall information was 42% at the end of the lecture, immediately after the classroom lecturing. 1 week later, the students' recall capacity has dropped to 20%. So, in the conventional lecturing style, so immediately after the class, if you conduct a test, 42% students will respond. 1 week later, if you conduct a test, the memory capacity, the recall capacity of the student has dropped to 20%. So, almost everybody will fail in the test. So, Lyon Gardner suggest that our current instructional procedure, remember, instructional procedure are not working very well. The students are not learning even the basic general knowledge. They are not developing higher level of cognitive skill. So, we know the Bloom's taxonomy, Bloom's cognitive level. So, the higher level is create, analyze, evaluate. So, up to apply, it is okay. Remember, understand, apply, it is okay. Right? Analyze, evaluate and create. So, that is what higher level of cognitive skill. Our students find it very difficult at the higher level and they are not retaining their knowledge very well. So, this is what the finding in 1994. So, significant learning experience for the students. So, if you talk about significant learning experience, the significant learning experience has both a process and outcome. What is the process? Students are engaged in their learning and the class has a higher energy level. So, that is what we call it as active learning. So, when you have active learning, participative learning, there will be significant learning experience for the students. When you just lecture in the classroom, it is only the students will be only passive listener. So, if you want to achieve or develop learning experience to the students, we have to involve them in the active learning process. Students are engaged in the learning and when you engage the students in the learning process, definitely the energy level inside the classroom will be very high. So, there will be some result, impact or the outcome out of the learning experience. Significant lasting change. So, course result in significant change in the students. The change that continues after the course is over and even after the student have graduated. So, when you involve them, active learning, then only it will lead to learning, lifelong learning. So, when you involve them in the active learning, it will promote the lifelong learning. So, lifelong learning is one component in the NBA accreditation. Value in life. What the student learn has the high potential for being of value in their lives after the course is over. By enhancing their individual lives, preparing them to participate in the multiple communities or preparing them for the world of work. So, the learning experience is possible only by engaging the students in the learning process. So, how to engage them in the learning process? That is where we have to design the lecture. It is not just preparing notes, the conventional way of preparing notes. It is only designing the instruction for a particular lecture. We take one analogy. So we go to the restaurant with the family and friends frequently or occasionally, sometimes the same restaurant. So what is the reason for going to the same restaurant, or what is the reason for going to a high quality restaurant? To provide high quality dining experience. So the restaurant which provide high quality dining experience. So what is high quality dining experience? It is by inviting menu, well prepared food, and prompt and thoughtful services. So these are all the few points that attract the restaurant, that is attracting us from towards the restaurant. Just to compare with the college classroom. What is inviting the student to the classroom? To provide high quality educational experience. So dining experience, we are going to the restaurant. For educational experience, how we provide high quality educational experience? It is by good infrastructure, good curriculum, good instruction, and a good interactive faculty. So when all the four things are here, the students will be invited. So that will give high quality educational experience to the students, and it will attract the students towards the classroom. So are we ready for the change? Are we the faculty member ready for a change? We faculty member have our own teaching method and style, derived from our teacher or inspired by our teacher. So every teacher, every one of us are inspired by our teacher, or we derive the teaching methodology from our teacher. So we are all already overloaded with our regular teaching, preparation, administration, documentation, everything. Despite, we have to change. So the teaching methodology what we are using present day, it is not promoting the learning experience in the student's mind. So we require something different. So should I spend the time and the effort to learn about to learn about and implement new way of teaching? Yes, it is worthwhile for me to invest in learning how to be a better teacher. So the investment, so we have to think how to be a better teacher for the present day situation. Either online teaching or offline teaching, we have to spend some time and effort to become a better teacher, to promote the learning experience in the student's mind. So do we have a dream for our teaching? Do we have a dream for our students during or after the graduation? So what is the imagination? Just to think. Imagine yourself teaching in a perfect situation where the students will do anything and everything you ask them. They will read everything and write everything you ask them to do. They will do it on time and do it well. It is a special situation. You can do everything you want as a teacher and have any kind of impact on the students that you desire. So this is imagination. Nowadays, nothing is happening inside the classroom. So it is only limitation of your own imagination. So what is my dream? What is your dream? Is that students 1 or 2 years after the course is over will be able to apply what they learn in real life situation. So apply and use what they learn in the real life situation. So the knowledge what they gain from the classroom, they should be able to apply to the real life situation. Find the way to make the world better and be able to make a difference. So they have to make a difference in their life. They have to make a difference in the professional life. Develop a deep curiosity for learning, for everything. Engage in lifelong learning. Experience joy of learning inside the classroom or outside the classroom. Take pride in what they have done and can accomplish in whatever discipline or line of work they choose. See the importance of community building both at work and in their personal lives. See the connection between themselves and their own belief, values and actions and those others. Think about problem and issues in integrated way rather than in separated and compartmentalized way. Students will see connections between multiple perspectives. See the need and change in the world and be changed agent. Be creative problem solver. Develop key skill, life skills such as communication skill. Understand and able to use the basic principles of my course. And stay positive despite the setbacks and challenges in life and work. Mentor others. So these are all the, continue to grow as a critical thinker. So these are all the some of the point, some of my imagination for the students. So all these things they have to learn. So if they want to achieve all these things, either inside the classroom or outside the classroom, in their professional life or the college life, it should be the inspiration or motivation is only from the classroom. So in the classroom, how we are making them for learn, how we are making them to learn, that will motivate them for further learning and to achieve all these things in their lives. And the value, continuous improvement. So they should focus on continuous improvement in their life. But to do all these things, so we have to understand the paradigm for teaching. So there are a separate article on paradigm for today's teaching. So you can refer to the Google and you can find many points on the shift in paradigm in the today's teaching. I have taken some 5 points. So the mission and purpose of today's teaching, criteria for success, learning, teaching and learning structure, nature of role, teaching assumption. So the mission and purpose in the old paradigm, what we follow, improving the quality of instruction. In yesteryears, 10 years back or 5 years back, the quality of instruction we have to improve. So, but today, improve the quality of learning. So, how the students have improved their learning ability, that is what the mission of the teaching today, that is what the purpose of teaching today inside the classroom. The criteria for success, earlier, the quality of entering students. So if you have a good quality student, they will be successful. But today, the quality of exiting student. Right? So based on the program outcome, based on the quality outcome, we have to create the students, the going outside the college of better quality. So that is what the criteria for success for today's teaching. Teaching and learning structure. Earlier, it was covering the material or covering the syllabus. If you cover the syllabus, you are the good teacher. But today, it is based on the specific learning objective or learning result. So, course outcome, lecture outcome, program outcome. It is based on the outcome or the objective. So, today's teaching and learning, it is based on the outcome. It is based on the objective and the result oriented. Nature of role. Earlier, the faculty members, they are the primarily lecturers. So, they are giving lecturers. They are lecturers in the classroom. They are lecturers. But today, faculty being designer of learning method and environment. So we have to design the learning methodology, learning material and learning experience for the students. And teaching assumption, any expert can teach yesterday. But today, teaching is a complex and require considerable training on the pedagogy. So not on the subject. So everyone, all the teachers today, they are very good, they have very good knowledge. But the pedagogy, the change in pedagogy is today requirement to give the experiential learning to the students. And understand, remember, ineffectiveness of the present day lecturing style, significant learning experience has a process and the outcome, the analogy of restaurant and the classroom, the dream for your student and your profession, and new paradigm for learning. So this is some of the points I observed, very interesting and useful in sharing. And from the book I want to plan few more lectures on the lecture design, the change in the lecture design, how to create significant learning experiences, and what are all the changes in the teaching method required to create learning experiences. This is what my plan. If I find time in future, I will make lectures on the instructional design, to create the learning experience. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. So if you have any queries, you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number. We'll meet again in another video lecture. Until then, bye.